Now let's head to Kabale, where in a bid to prevent the spread of COVID-19, authorities have vowed to use tougher measures to stop the spread of COVID-19. This as the country battles COVID-19.
I found that there are some challenges to do with the health workers, because since last year, these are the people that have been at it, and that gives them fatigue, either collectively or individually.
In a joint meeting of stakeholders in the COVID-19 task force at the Kabale district headquarters, authorities agreed to deal strongly with people who are not respecting the guidelines from the Ministry of Health and the presidential directives. According to the Chigezi Regional Police spokesman, Eli Mate, the task force has so far identified the leading sources of COVID-19 transmission, and they will not compromise efforts to handle it.
Stop the spread of the transmission, we looked at the source. We said we can do this by right away working on the source of transmission. And we looked at the source as burial places, which brings people together. We all looked at the markets, because some markets are not controllable and it hosts many people, and some of them who are reckless and don't care. We looked at borders who think that they are very wise and they dodge here and there. We've looked at truck drivers who are still carrying people.
The meeting has also agreed charges to be levied on impounded vehicles. This will now be 100,000 shillings from 40,000 Ugandan shillings.
We have agreed that some people think that whenever we impound, they will always come in as friends, as colleagues and what. Of course, we have been issuing them with EPS, with receipts. But we have agreed that we should make these receipts bigger, the amount of 100, more especially those found in curfew, beyond curfew hours, and those found carrying passengers.
According to the UPDF 2nd Division Commander, Major General Francis Takidwa, some challenges, especially in supplies, have been identified by the teams implementing the prevention and care of COVID-19.
Fatigue, and in such situations, they end up committing mistakes because the period of alertness also expires, and now it turns into routine.
Darius Nandinda, the Kabale Resident District Commissioner, commended locals for respecting the SOPs in second wave of the lockdown. A vendor at Kabale Central Market say despite their willingness to observe the presidential guidelines, they are still failing to find means of accommodation within the market due to its setup. This story was compiled by Job Namanya for the news in Kabale.